Hello guys, welcome back once again. This is Jagrat here, and we can see here that we have already completed the four topics. Okay, so today we are going to cover the most important topic, that is the Java loop statements. Okay, how can we use loop in our Java code? Okay, we will see. So let's start. Okay, so firstly we need to understand why actually different types of loop we needed. Okay, what is the purpose of these loops? Okay, so let me create one class. Loops concept. Okay, select this public static void main checkbox and click on finish. Okay, so firstly we need to understand why this loop concept is needed. Okay, what is the purpose of this loop? Okay, let me clear this. Yeah. Okay, let us suppose there is a requirement that you need to print the number from 1 to 10. Okay, so let us suppose if you don't know the concept of loops, okay, then what you will do, you will just type the system.out.println. okay, and print 1. Okay, like this. And 10 times you will type like this. Okay, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so here you will write 2, here you will write 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay guys, and when you will run this, it will give you the output like this. See, 1 to 10. Okay, but guys, 10 is very small number. Okay, let us suppose if you want to print the number from 1 to 1000. Okay, then will you write like this 1000 times? Of course no. Okay, so this would be a very bad approach. Okay, but guys, please see very carefully, we are writing a code, we are writing the same code again and again. Okay, system.out.println1, system.out.println2, 3, 4. Okay, so here the concept of loop is introduced. Okay, so let us suppose if you want to write a certain piece of code, okay, which I know that yes, this particular certain piece of code will repeat again and again, then we will use the concept of loops. Okay, so if, let us suppose if there is a certain piece of code that yes, we know that this particular code is repeated, this particular code will repeat again and again, okay, in our code, then we will apply the concept of loops in our code. Okay guys, so the first point is like this. If certain piece of code is repeated again and again, then we will use loops. Okay, now I think you have a clearance regarding it, that when we will use the concept of loops. Okay, because guys, you can see here, let us suppose if you want to print the number from 1 to 10,000, then you cannot write like this statement 10,000 times. No, this is a very bad approach. Okay, so we will use the concept of loops. Okay, so what are the different types of loops? Okay, what are the different types of loops? We will see this one by one. First is while loop. Okay guys, second is for loop. Third is do while loop. Okay, and fourth is for each loop, or we can say enhanced for loop. Okay, this is a new type of loop which is introduced after, you know, the Java 1.5 version. Okay, this is from Java 1.5 version. Okay, as we are using the JDK 1.8, I think, so we can use this particular for each loop, or we can say enhanced for loop. Okay, so basically there are four types of loop here. Okay, so firstly let's discuss about, you know, first type of loop, that is while loop. Okay, this is the first loop that we need to discuss. So what is the syntax of loop? Let's see first the syntax of loop, and then we will do some code in the Eclipse IDE. Okay, so what is the syntax? First we will write the initialization part. Okay, so this is the initialization part. Then while, here we will write some condition. Okay, so this is called conditional part. Okay guys, always remember this w should be small. Okay, so this is the conditional part, and then write your code here. Okay, whatever code you want to write, just write your code here. Then here incremental or decremental part. Okay guys, and then close this curly braces. So guys, this is the, you know, basic syntax of while loop. Okay, so this is the basic syntax of while loop. So let's see, I will remove this type of code. Okay, so first is while loop. Okay, so guys, see the syntax. First is the initialization part. Okay, so let us suppose if I want to print a number from 1 to 10. Okay, so how can we write like this? Firstly, we will declare a one variable. Let us suppose a, and we will initialize the value with 1. Why? Because we want to print a number from 1 to 10. So we will start from 1. So guys, this is the initialization part. Okay, initialization part. Okay, now let's put the condition here, while a is less than or is equal to 10. Okay, so this is the conditional part. Okay, what will what we actually want to do, we want to print the number. Okay, so system.out.println a. Okay, so this is your code. Okay, this is your code statement part. Okay guys, and now please ignore the typo guys. Okay, and now what is the next? Next is the incremental or decremental part. Okay, so we will increase the value like this. Okay guys, this is the incremental part. Okay, I have already told you the concept of incremental or decremental operators. Okay guys, this a plus plus means a is equal to a plus 1. Okay guys, so how this loop will work? Okay, let's see. Firstly, what is the value of a? 1. Okay, then it will enter into the condition 1 is less than 10, less than or is equal to 10, condition true. Okay, if the condition true, then this block will be executed. So current, what is the value of a? 1. So system.out.println a means 1 is getting printed. Okay guys, means 1 is getting printed. Okay, now a plus plus. Now what is the value of a? 2, because a is equal to a plus 1. Okay, so now the value of 2, again it will check the condition 2 is less than or is equal to 10. Yes, then it will print again 2. Okay, again a plus plus means now the value of a is 3. So 3 is less than or is equal to 10, condition again true. If true, then it will print 3. Okay, again a plus plus, 4. 4 is less than or is equal to 10, condition true. Okay, then it will print 4. Same case for again 5. 5 is less than or is equal to 10, it will print 5. Again, what is the value of a? 6. 6 is less than or is equal to 10, it will print 6. Okay, again a plus plus, what is the value of a? 7. 7 is less than or is equal to 10, print 7. Okay, again a plus plus. Okay, now the value of a is 8. 8 is less than or is equal to 10, condition again 2. So it will print 8. Okay, again a plus plus. So 9 is less than or is equal to 10, condition true. Okay, again a plus plus means 10. 10 is less than or is equal to 10, condition true. Okay, 10 is less than or is equal to 10, condition true. So if the condition will be true, then it will print 10. Now again a plus plus, now the value of a is 11. So it will check the condition 11 is less than or is equal to 10, condition false. So when the condition will be false, it will come outside from the while loop. Okay, and the program will terminate. Okay guys, so this is the, you know, sequence how actually it will work. Okay, so let's run this program. You can see here 1 to 10. Okay, let us suppose if you want to print the number from 0, then just start a from 0. Okay, let's run this and you can see here it will print from 0 to 10. Okay, let us suppose if you want to print the number from 0 to 9 only, then you have to remove this equals to. Okay, you can see here 0 to 9. Okay guys, so this is the concept of, you know, while loop. Okay, now we will move towards in the next concept, next, you know, type of loop, that is for loop. Okay, okay, so before going towards for loop, let me tell you one more thing. It's a, I mean, this is the very famous and common interview question, that what is the, you know, disadvantage of while loop? Okay. It's a very famous interview question, that what is the disadvantage of while loop? Okay. So the main disadvantage is, if this while loop is not properly coded, okay, then it will give you infinite loop. Okay, guys. Let me show you how. Let us suppose I commented this line. Okay. So if I commented this line, that it means Java compiler will not execute this line. Okay. So now what will happen? Again, be a compiler, guys. Okay. Int a is equal to 1. 1 is less than 10. Condition true. It will print 1. Okay. But there is no increment part, so that the value of a will never increase. So currently the value of a will be 1. Again, 1 is less than 10. Again, it will print 1. Again, 1 is less than 10. Again, it will print 1. Okay. So it will enter into the infinite loop. Okay. So let's run this program, guys. And you can see here. See, guys. See this scroll bar. Okay. It is still running. And 11111 is continuously printing. Okay. So I have already told you why it is printing 111 again and again. So guys, this is the, you know, disadvantage of while loop. If while loop is not properly coded, then it will give infinite loop. Okay. So let's terminate it. So for terminating, you can use this red sign. You can see here, it will give you a tooltip property, terminate. Okay. So just click on it. So you can see here, guys, 11111 is getting printed. Okay. So this is the, you know, main disadvantage of while loop. This is a very famous interview question, guys. Okay. So please remember this. Okay. Now let's enter to the, into the for loop. Okay. So let's see the syntax. So what is the syntax for? Okay, here initialization part is there. I will copy this and I will paste this. Okay, this f should be, you know, small. Okay, so this is the initialization part, then semicolon, then conditional part. Okay, then semicolon, and then incremental or decremental part. Okay, guys, incremental or decremental part. Okay, then let's start the loop. Okay, and write your code here and just close the brackets. Okay, guys, so this is the syntax of, you know, for loop. Okay, so generally, you know, for loop is used when we want to repeat our code with a specified number of time, then we generally use the for loop. Okay, we know during the code that yes, till this time, I mean till this count, our code will execute. Okay, then we generally use the for loop. Okay, guys, so let's make our code for the for loop. Okay, so let me distinguish this. Okay, so here it is for loop. Okay guys, so we will start for loop from here, so that when output will print, then you can easily understand. So for loop, okay. So guys, I will change this code as per the syntax for loop. Okay, so you can easily relate while loop, for loop, and then remaining of the loops. Okay, then we will do some experiments also. Okay, so again I am going to print the number from 1 to 10. So for, okay, as you can see here, initialization part is integer a is equal to 1. Okay, so int a, we have to take the something different variable, because duplicate variables are not allowed. I have already told you the concept in the previous session. Okay, so this is our initialization part. Okay, then what is the conditional part? B. Okay, so B is less than or is equal to 10, and what is our incremental part? Plus plus. Okay, so B plus plus. Okay, and what is our code statement? System.out.println, like this. Okay, and we will put here B. So guys, you can see here we regenerate our code with the help of for loop. Okay guys, so let's print this code. See guys, this is the code for while loop and this is the code for loop. 1 to 10 is printed. Okay guys, so this is the, you know, basic structure of for loop. Okay, now the thing is, this is let us suppose incremental part. Okay, I want to show you the some decremental part also. Okay, so let's see some decremental part also. Okay, so how can we use okay, so let us suppose we want to print the number from 10 to 1. Okay, from 10 to 1. Okay, so we have to start number from 10. Okay, so int c is equal to 10. And what will be the condition? C is greater than or is equal to 1. Okay, and c minus minus. See guys, we are using the decremental part, c minus minus. Okay, so how this loop will execute? C is equal to 10, 10 is greater than or is equal to 1, condition true, condition true, then it will print c, means 10 is getting printed. Okay, then c minus minus means 10 minus 1, 9. Again check the condition, 9 is greater than or is equal to 1, condition true, 9 will print. Again c minus minus, 8, 8 is greater than or is equal to 1, condition true, 8 will print. Again 7, 7 is greater than or is equal to 1, 7 print. Again 6, 6 is greater than or is equal to 1, 6 print. Again 5, 5 is greater than or is equal to 1, condition true, 5 print. Again 4, 4 is greater than or is equal to 1, 4 print. Again 3, 3 is greater than or is equal to 1, 3 print. Again 2, 2 is greater than or is equal to 1, 2 print. again 1. 1 is greater than or equal to 1, condition true. So 1 is getting printed. Again 0. 0 is greater than or equal to 1, condition false. So as soon as the condition will be false, it will come outside from the for loop. Okay guys, so let's run this program. So guys, you can see here, it will print like this. See, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay guys, any problem? Okay, so I think you can also use the decremental part. Okay, now let's move towards the our next type of loop, that is do while loop. Okay, so what is the syntax here? Again, first is the initialization part. Okay guys, first is the initialization part, then do. Okay, this D should be capital, then write your code here. Okay, then curly braces close, and here we will give the while and conditional part. Okay, like this. Okay guys, so this is the syntax of do while loop. Okay, so let's create the code for do while loop also. Okay guys, so this is for do while loop. Do while loop. Okay, so let's make it a proper alignment. Okay, okay, so let's start the third type of loop, that is do while loop. So again, first is the initialization part. Okay, so int d is equal to 1. Okay guys, I am using the same program because you can easily understand that to print the number from 1 to 10, how can we write it, I mean this program, in while loop? How can we write the same program in, you know, for loop, with the help of for loop? And how can we write the same program with the help of do while loop? Okay, so int d is equal to 1, do. Okay, so we need to print the numbers, so let me write the code here. Okay, this is d, and then d plus plus. Okay, like this. Okay, okay, so we did not give the incremental or decremental part, so let's keep this also. Okay, like this. Okay guys, and now what we will do, just impose a condition. What is the condition? D is less than or is equal to 10. Okay guys, so this is the, you know, structure of do while loop. Okay, so let's run this and see whether number will be print or not. Yes, you can see here, guys. See, do while loop and 1 to 10 number will be print. Guys, this is a, one more famous common interview question, that what is the difference between you know, while loop and do while loop. Okay, so in the do while loop, our statement code, our code, or we can say our code statement must be executed at least once. Okay, this line of code will execute at least once. Okay, but this is not the necessary condition for while loop. Okay, so how can we explain this? Let's make a separate class for this. Okay, difference between while and do while. Okay guys, let's see what is the difference. Okay, so let me copy the code, guys. This is our while loop. Okay, and this is our do while. Okay guys, this is a very famous interview question, especially for the freshers. Okay, but sometimes they might be asked from the experienced guy also, 2 to 3 years, 2 years of experience. Okay, so this is while. Okay guys, so now let's make some changes in the program. Okay, let's make some changes. Like this. Okay, now guys, just see the clear difference. You can easily understand the clear difference. Okay, let's run. Firstly, we will see the while loop. So int a is equal to 1. Okay, then it will enter into the condition. 1 is less than or is equal to 0. Condition false. So condition false, then it will automatically comes out of, you know, while loop. Okay, but guys, in do while loop, you can see here, int d is equal to 1, it will enter into this loop. What is the value of d currently? 1. Okay, 1. So it will print 1. Now what is the value of d? 2. Okay, then it will check the condition, 2 is less than 0. No, then it will outside from the, you know, do while loop. Okay, so in this case you can see here, our code statement must be executed at least once. Our code statement will be executed at least once. Okay, so let's run this program, guys. See the difference, guys. Okay, this is for while loop. So under this while loop, nothing is printed. Okay, but do while loop, you know, 1 is printed, because this statement is executing once. Okay, so this is the, you know, basic difference between while and do while loop. As we can easily see that in do while loop, the code statement will be executed at least once. Okay. So I think you can easily understand the difference now. Okay. So we will move further. And the last topic. That is the, you know, for each loop. Okay. For each loop, or we can say enhanced for loop. Okay. This is our last topic. Okay. So how can we implement this? Let's move towards the loops concept again. Let me close this. Okay, let me copy this and paste it here so that you can easily understand. Enhanced for loop. Okay. So guys, firstly, I would like to tell you regarding this, because this is a new, you know, for loop for you guys. So basically, this enhanced for loop is generally used to traverse array or collections. Okay. Just forget these words, array or collection. I will tell you in the further sessions. Don't worry about it. Okay. Just remember this, that it is generally used. Okay. Let me make a notes for you guys. So used to traverse array or collection in Java. Okay, so this is the first point. The second point is, it is very, you know, easier than simple for loop. Okay, see this. This is for loop. Okay, so it is very easier than simple for loop, because we don't need to increment value. Guys, please listen my lines very carefully. Okay. It is very easier than simple for loop because we don't need to increment value and use subscript notation. Okay. So let me write this. So easier than simple for loop because we don't need to increment value and use subscript notation. Okay. I will tell you the concept of subscript notation when I will, you know, move towards the concept of arrays. Okay. Guys, you can see here in the for loop, we use incremental or decremental part. Okay. But in this case, there is no need. Okay. When I will write the code for each loop, then you can see. Okay. And the next thing, it works on, guys, this is also the very important point. So it works on element basis. Okay. Not index basis. Okay. So when anyone asks that what is the, you know, enhanced for loop, then you need to tell these three points. Okay. You have to tell these three points. Okay. So now I am going to write the code for enhanced for loop. Guys, it is very simple. Okay. So let's define an array. Okay. Just see what is array. I will tell you in the further sessions. Okay. So this is the, you know, array. Let me give some different name as a variable I have already used. Okay. Let us suppose we have an array in which these elements are present. Okay. So what we will do simply, guys, see this syntax. Okay, firstly let me write this syntax, then I will tell you how the things are going on. Yeah, that's it. Okay guys, so the first point is used to traverse array or collection in Java. So I am taking here the example of array. Okay, you can see here, this is our array. Okay, just see, don't need to understand what is array or what is something like that. Okay, I will tell you in the further sessions. Okay, then that what is array, what is the concept. Okay, don't worry about it. I will tell you in the further sessions. So this is the array. Okay, and there are some elements that we have already initialized in this array. Okay, now this is our, you know, enhanced for loop. Okay, this is our enhanced for loop. Okay, so what actually this loop is, it will pick element from this array one by one. Okay, let us suppose this array is, you can see here, this ARR array we define. So how it works, see, firstly 12, this 12 element will pick. Okay, it will store in this particular variable I, and then it will print that particular element. So in the first, 12 will store to I and 12 will print, then it will automatically move towards the next element. There is no need to define the, you know, increment part. There is no need to define the increment part. Okay, so the next value is 44. 44 will store in variable I and 44 will print. Then it will move towards the next element, 56. 56 will store in the variable I and it will store, I mean it will print 56. Then it will move towards 68. 68 will store in the variable I and it will print 68. And it will move towards the, again, the, you know, next element 78. It will store in the value I and again it will print 78. As there are, I mean, there is no next element, so it will automatically moved out from the for loop. Okay guys, so let's run this. Let me clear this console. Okay, and now let's run this program. What is this? Let me run this again. Yeah, I think there is some problem in Eclipse. Okay, so you can see here guys, enhanced for loop and 12, 44, 56, 68, 78. Okay guys, so that's why I'm saying it works on element basis. So it picks one element from the array and it will print. It will pick again the next element from the array and it will print. Okay guys, so I think this is all about the loops concept. Okay, so this session is also completed. Please practice, okay, and make your core Java very strong. Okay, so guys, this session is also completed. So in the next session we will see the concept of access modifiers, okay, like public, what is private, protected, something like that. Okay, so guys, if you really like this video, then please like, share and subscribe. Okay, so see you soon in the next session. Okay, thank you guys, thank you very much, bye.